Hello, long time no see. How's it going? How are the kids? I'm very well, thanks. Thanks for asking. In today's video, we're going to talk about Photoshop's brand new addition to Adobe Camera Raw, and that is super resolution, which allows you to increase your image size 4 times as well as significantly enhancing the quality. Is it any good, and how does it compare to Topaz Gigapixel? You'll find out in this video. All right, so make sure you head over to the Adobe Creative Cloud app and download the latest updates for Photoshop and Camera Raw because you won't get this super resolution feature without doing that. And now, without further ado, here is the super resolution workflow in 10 seconds. Inside Camera Raw, right-click on your image, click Enhance. You can click around the image window, then just click on the preview window to see the before and after. And as you can see, the little Lacoste crocodile is sharper in the super resolution preview. Now, I want to point out that just because this is upscaling your image 4 times, it does not mean it's going to be 4 times sharper. While it does perform very well with raw files, the most you're going to get is 2 times sharper. And that's also after you've done some further editing within Camera Raw. So after we click Enhance, Camera Raw will create a duplicate of this image. And what I'm going to do is go to the Detail menu and adjust some of these. So I'm going to increase the sharpening to my liking, add a little bit of noise reduction, and in the main window, I'm going to enhance the clarity as well. Now I'm simply going to hit open and save this as a new file. Okay, I'm definitely seeing a noticeable difference here on the Lacoste logo. On the right, it actually is identifiable. On the left, it's just a bunch of pixels. Here's one of my images from the back wall, and yeah, again, noticeably sharper and better on the right-hand side. And one more comparison, here is the door handle, and if you look particularly at this area here, and you look at the same part on the right, it actually has clearly defined edges there. So my verdict on super resolution, yes, it's absolutely worth doing. It's a free update, you don't have to pay for it, and it smooths out these pixely and soft lines when you might be lacking resolution. If you're a 360 photographer like me, many of the cameras out there don't have all the resolution in the world. So you need a few editing tricks in your tool bag to help those 360 photos look sharper. Now the question remains, how does this new Photoshop feature compare to Topaz Gigapixel, which is a completely separate paid software by Topaz Labs, and its primary focus is doing the exact same thing that this new super resolution does. And here it is, I've made a video about it in the past if you check out the previous videos on my channel, and it's a really simple interface, yet you can do quite a few things in regards to sharpening and suppressing noise. And that's also something I love about Topaz software, is it both suppresses noise and sharpens images in most of their softwares. And I found Gigapixel to be the best and my favorite, as well as Denoise. I like them both probably equally, but for this particular purpose, which is increasing image size and quality, I found working with Gigapixel to be a great experience.
A few moments later.
Okay, so here the three are side by side, the original Photoshop Super Resolution and Topaz Gigapixel. And there's no question the two on the right are much better than the original. And there's pros and cons of both Photoshop and Gigapixel. I think they both look significantly sharper. I can see more detail in the crocodile with Gigapixel. However, it also does look a little bit sharpened. That was probably my fault for over-sharpening it. Sometimes I get overexcited, but there's no question both Photoshop and Gigapixel have done a good job. All right, let's move around to another one of my prints. And this is a tiny planet I shot in Iceland back in the days when we could travel. Hope those days come back soon. But yeah, I think Gigapixel is the best by far in this situation. And I found generally Gigapixel has been best for architecture, landscapes, basically anything that doesn't have people in it. Okay, this is a good one. This is my YouTube award hanging above my desk. And look at how good Gigapixel did here. Firstly, it's sharper than the other two with edges much more clearly defined, but also it's done a great job at denoising and getting rid of those ugly imperfections. Okay, so when you put the two sharpening softwares side by side, Gigapixel definitely wins. However, it also does come with some cons. The first con is it's paid. It's another software you have to pay for, whereas if you're paying for a Photoshop subscription, you don't need to pay anything else to get this new super resolution feature. Secondly, I found with Gigapixel, you need a really fast computer for it to run smoothly. And I'm talking a minimum of 32 gigabytes of RAM, maybe about an 8 gigabyte graphics card, and still it can freeze and take a really long time to export. So don't even think about Gigapixel if you have a slow computer. So yeah, that's it. That's super resolution. I'll link both of the softwares I mentioned in this video down below. And if you have any other workflow tips or hacks or other softwares that you've found a lot of success with in upscaling your images and increasing that image quality, feel free to share them down below. It's been fun. It's been real. Subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time.